One more minute. Seconds, we're gonna let this song go through. And that's how we start our Monday afternoon call. Without me butchering the end of a song or transition of a song, I should say. So welcome, guys. Happy Monday. This is the New England Growth Call. How many of you, this is your first time on the call? Just put it in the chat or unmute. All of you are have returned. All right, I want to see how many of you have been here since March 1st. Put in the chat if you've been here. Lee, I know you have been. I see you all the time. High five, Lee. I wish I could really high five you. Steven, you're new. Welcome. I think you might love it. Some people love it. I love it. It's part of my favorite part on a Monday. Jody, you've been here. Evelyn, you guys rock. So before we dive into our content today, I would love to hear from you guys. Especially Lee and those of you who have been with us since March 1st, what do you like about this call? Do you like speakers? Do you like the content? Do you like the in and the out of the 30 minutes? Like, tell me a little bit about what you like about this call. And this is where I'd love for you guys to unmute yourself or put in the chat, and Brooke and Cassie could help us with those comments.
I love the content.
Lisa, you love the content. Anyone in particular that you really loved? That like was your favorite?
Actually, I liked the two of last week, the five, and then the ice cream one. I waited for a warm day to post that one.
And tell me, did you get a lot of interaction with that?
No, but I just started doing this with you guys like a little over a week ago, so I know it's coming.
All right. Well, I'll tell you, I saw Nate Dickey, our original director. He posted it about the ice cream shot. And the last time I looked, he had 22 comments on where the best ice cream shop is in New Hampshire. So I don't know what's going on with New Hampshire. Did anyone have more than 22 comments from their ice cream post? That's a lot, right? That's a lot of recommendations for ice cream.
That's a ton.
A ton, right? Now, what do you think you would do with 22 comments? Do you have any suggestions?
Maybe bring those back to command, put those flavors in, and then when you eat at those stops, make sure to tag them in your posts, or talk to those ice cream places and get some discount tickets, or offer to buy ice cream punch cards, something where you post about them. This is a great way to also have a vendor touch, not just a consumer touch.
Absolutely. I mean, hands down, yes. There is so much you could do with those responses that you got. And even if you didn't get any, guess what you could do? You go find 5 ice cream spots in your area and highlight them. Maybe go interview that vendor, that ice cream shop, and say, why do you always have such a long line here? And put a post on, and I bet you they'll help you with some marketing as well. Right, Brooke? You think that
Absolutely.
Could happen?
Absolutely. They, trust me, they are not going to turn down free marketing. They're not going to turn it down, especially if you ask them what flavor they run out of the fastest.
Absolutely. All right. Did you see any other comments on what they like? Or tell me.
So we're seeing energy. They love the energy that we bring to the region. Accountability, and that it is short, sweet, and super helpful.
It is short for sure. Like I'm exhausted as soon as this call is over, because I feel like we got to get in. We got to give you guys the good content. We got to get out and keep moving, right? So I'm exhausted by 2:30 on a Monday. I don't know. Is anybody else? Is it just me?
No, I'm there with you. I'm there with you.
All right. Anything else that we're missing before we keep going?
Yeah. So with engagement on posts, Brooke, maybe you can give me like the technical background side of this. I don't know. But I notice on my own posts, anytime I like have a tag a location, tag a person, I automatically get that in front of more people. Mm-hmm. I feel like the Facebook algorithm just has it show up. So if you're doing those posts and you feel like you're not having a lot of engagement, maybe like check in at a location, check in at your market center, check in at the region, tag a friend, like a group of friends, a group of realtors, whatever you want to do. I know on mine, that helps get more engagement. Brooke, maybe you can give us the tech version of that.
Absolutely. And make sure you're using your business page and sharing it back so you're getting it in front of more people. When you tag that location, your public business page is bringing in a whole audience that may not see those because they see it wherever you tagged it if they follow it. So doing stuff like that will help bring up your visibility as well. So tag those ice cream places, tag the region, tag your market centers, tag people.
All right. And I have a really crazy question to ask the group. This is crazy. And this is like still trying to get my brain around it, but how many of you would attend an in-person growth call for maybe an hour and a half to two if we held one within the region? How many of you would attend that? If it was within, let's say, 2 hours of where you are. Do costumes, Brooke? I mean, you could wear a total Keller Williams t-shirt. That's our costumes, right? All right, so we're getting some people. We got Steve, I see your hands up. Oh, I couldn't even read your name. You put your hand down so fast, but I saw there was another one up. All right, so yeah, keep your eye out for that because we're looking to plan some in-person stuff. And we obviously, there's two hands now. Jen, thank you. High five, thumbs up, clap, I think whatever that was. We're going to be planning some in-person events and we love your support on those kind of things. So keep an eye out for it. Absolutely depends on location and travel time. We're going to keep that. We're going to have that into consideration when we plan any of our events for the rest of 21 and 22. Cassie, anything you want to add to that?
Nope, you got it all.
All right. I got a thumbs up from Steven. All right, here we go. You ready to get into some content, ladies? Let's do this. All right. So for this week, the week of June 21st, guess today is the first full day of summer in New England, right? Summer, one of those days. So, all right, so it's the first full day. We're gonna share our screen here, Cassie, and show them what our content is for this week. Thanks, Brooke. All right, so this week we're going to provide to you an email for your data bank and or database, whatever you call your database. Keller Williams likes to call it a data bank. Why do you think they call it a data bank, Brooke?
No money. It gives you all your money, all your business. Better data bank, better business. No data bank, no business.
It's a bank. It really is a bank for your business. So that's your data bank. So we're going to provide you with an email to send out to your data bank. And then we're also going to include 2 lovely social media graphics for you to use. All right, let's scroll to the email. And this is a quick email, and you might have sent something out similar to this. Yeah, it has a little different spin on it. It says, why the refi is in the subject line. And just a little catchy tagline to send out to your data bank. And obviously it says, can you believe summer's here? Because how quickly did that come up and how quickly is, okay, we're gonna talk about summer in the now. We're gonna talk about summer. And I wore my first day of summer dress today because it's summery, right?
It's very summery.
For me, in color, that's a big deal. So
I know, right? I'm still living in my black and red.
All right. Can't believe summer is here. Any big plans coming up? And then it goes into some refi ideas and why right now could be a great opportunity for them to refi. It includes a great little article right on in this email that they could click on, and it takes them right to that article. Quick little email. And why do you think, Cassie, Brooke, why would we send out a refi email right now?
Because the rates are the lowest.
The rates are pretty low right now.
Rates are still very low. And it's a great way to gauge interest of maybe refi or sell. Love it or list it.
Love that. Yes, absolutely. All right, let's keep going and go right into our social media graphic. This is a really fun one. Erica found this one, and I just think it's really cool to know. How many of you know the history of a housewarming party? Well, guess what? You're going to find out today how the housewarming party was formed. And if you don't want to read the little screen there, I'm not sure if you could see it, but I'm going to tell you what it says is that back in the day when mortgage rates were 15% to 20%, they used to have different loan programs. And what it would be is they would have a balloon payment at the end, and that would be almost as much as their down payment. So when people would pay off their loan and it would be free and clear, they would have a party to burn their mortgage paperwork. And that's how a housewarming party was formed. Yet in today's day, they flip that right around. And now they have them when you first sign your mortgage. That's typical for us here. But you can see it's just a fun little fact to share with your social media friends and get some engagement on it. It says, and you thought the shindig was just to get some swag for the abode. Turns out that there's real history behind the housewarming party. Cool little fact, right? All right, let's go to the next one. And then the last one here for your second one for the week is always a this or a that. How many of us are listening to podcasts and playlists right now? All right, specifically, I'm gonna go to the podcast people. Drop in the chat, what's your favorite podcast? What are you listening to right now that's your favorite podcast? I'm gonna drop mine in too. CEA is not the right one. CEO is probably a better one. The other one that I would put in here, look at that. A lot of us are thinking like a CEO and listening to it. What is it called? Oh my goodness.
Trailblazers. I'm trying to find the link.
Not Trailblazers. I'm thinking of the Amplify Girls, which Empire Builders. That's another one that I love to listen to. So between those two, those are my favorite right now. I'm going to save this chat. And Brooke, you think we could put that into the Facebook group so that way we could post that?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Awesome. Keep posting in there your favorite podcast, because we're going to come up with a list ourselves that you might not be aware of, and we could share them. But here we go. Here is your Thursday post of this or that. I am definitely a podcast listener in my car. Going to the office, I listen to podcasts. When I leave the office, I listen to my playlist.
Same.
Do you do the same thing? Like when I go home, I want to listen to some really cool music and like debrief from the day. But on my way in, I'm all about the business. Like, give me something good to say today.
Yes. One nugget to take into work with me. Yeah. One nugget.
Absolutely. Yeah. All right. So Brooke, that's our content for this week.
I love this one. And guys, if you are unsure how to pre-post these things, talk to your MCTTs, jump on our Thursday training calls, because a lot of the things we do cover how to do this. So what we give you these things on a Monday, it's going to be 2:30. So time block from 2:30 to 3 to get this stuff into your command and set it and forget it. Get these people on smart plans, send the emails or the text messages, make this so easy that the rest of the week you post what you want when something comes up. These things happen automatically because you're putting them in command. Set it, forget it. It's a Ronco. It's a rotisserie chicken at the end of the night, and it's perfect. It's perfect.
You and Jason Abrams, the analogies are just...
I'm a food-motivated animal. It always comes back to food with me.
I think so, actually. Yeah, you're right. All right, guys. So that's what we have this week. By the way, we are still doing a drawing today. And Cassie, how do you get involved in our weekly drawing?
So our emails that go out every week, I think they're Fridays and Mondays right now, they have a link that you can fill out the just quick survey, just what are you doing, like from this call each week, how many listings are you getting, how are you doing, you fill that out, come on the call, and then you have a chance to win whatever we're giving away each week.
That's all you have to do is just let us know that you are making your calls, you're coming on these calls, you're getting a listing, a buyer. That's all. So there it is. See how quickly she dropped that in that chat. Fill that form out each week, and that's how you enter into this drawing. And by the way, you have to be here to win. We have 70 people. So Cassie, are you ready to do this drawing? We're gonna do it early. We're gonna get in. We're gonna get out. We're gonna go do our business. All right, let's go.
All right, we have randomly selected from our entries in the last week. I'm sorry, as always, if I butcher your name, Stephen B. I'm just going to give you the last initial, B as in boy, from coastal New Hampshire. Are you on the call?
Is it B-U-I-A?
It is.
He
can
is
you help me out?
I don't know how to say it either. I'm with you on that one. Hopefully he
passed. Where is he? Let's see if we can get
Stephen,
him.
Are you here? You want to unmute?
It's Beulah. Three vowels and a consonant. You can't believe how they butcher it.
Beulah. Perfect. I'm going to remember that one.
Let's pin him and pin. Where are you? All right. Here we go. Cassie, please tell Stephen what he has won today.
Well, Stephen, today you get a choice of three different options. We have our cooler, which is great for the summer. I use it quite often, actually. We go to softball games, the town softball games, and we get to pack a little cooler there. We have our Onward t-shirt, some swag from the region. Onward, Brooke is modeling it for us right over there with the regional logo, or a Profit First book. So you'll get your choice. Stephen will send it right over to you.
Cooler.
You got it.
All right, Stephen. Wait, before you leave, Stephen, I have to know, what are you doing with this content and how is it working for you?
Well, this is the first time. I apologize. And because I've been just doing a lot of things around the house and not being able to get on all the time. So this is great. It brings a lot of people together, and they're all friends, and it's a team environment, and that's what makes it great.
Well, you know, I love that you said that. And I love that this is one of your first times on and you're one of our winners. So congratulations. I love that. And you know what? Stephen just brought up a really good point, guys. So there are still 64 of you on here. How many of you know each other? How many of you know each other, right? So if you don't know people on this list, this is your network. We do these things so that way you guys can connect with each other. And when there are referrals, Stephen, did you ever know anybody traveling or buying in Rhode Island?
No.
Well, you might. It's the wrong answer. Well,
I'm licensed both in New Hampshire and Mass. So, you know, New Hampshire and Mass works for me.
Yeah, absolutely. So what I'm getting at is there are people that are moving all throughout New England. And when you have your referral resource set where you know who you're going to send them to, like Lorna, would I always send my referrals up to you? Absolutely. Why?
Because you love me and you know I'm going to take good care of them.
Because I love you and I know you would take good care. Absolutely. The thing is I know Lorna and we have a great working network, friendship, right? So that's how it works, guys. So if you don't know what everybody on this, go pick five people to just introduce yourself to and really get to know them and send your referrals to each other. All right. That's all we got for today, guys.
Can I do one more thing?
Yes.
Can we do a shameless plug for our MREA series? How many of you on here have been joining us in the mornings? Okay, so I don't see enough hands on my front screen. There's the link, register. You can't get there, guess what? You're able to replay it, but guys, we are getting nuggets of gold every single day. How many were on today, this morning? I see a couple of people I know who were. You thought the budget model was boring? If you didn't see it, rewatch it. Mind blown by some of the stuff that we are told today. And I'm not giving you any replay. It. Go see it. It was amazing.
And all the resources are all there for you too. So if, by the way, I tasked everybody on that call to either go start a personal budget and or start a business budget if you do not have one. So 57 of you on here, if you do not have a personal budget and or a business budget, I'm giving that task to you as well. Go start your budget today. Go watch that MREA series from this morning. You will not be upset that you did. It's going to be a wealth of information for you to get started knowing your numbers. Really good plug, Brooke.
Numbers. Definitely. Yeah, you gotta know your numbers, kid.
We'll be on Wednesday morning at 8:30. 8:30, yeah. We'll be on going over the organizational model and we hope to see you there. So that's all we have for today, guys. Have a wonderful rest of your Monday. Thanks for coming on.
Bye, guys. Go be good.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.